to Choose Lovingkindness, chat with Venerable Bhante Sujatha. This is the first episode that Bhante is doing, and he's going to continue these conversations around the globe in his travels. And Bhante, what we were talking about is that this is going to be a series where you're going to be answering some questions that you receive from students all around the globe, and that is about just their questions and concerns about their spiritual journey.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking, because when I'm traveling around the world, you know, sometimes people sending me lots of email asking those questions. Now I have so many questions in my head, I feel that they are not answered yet. Mm-hmm. So I was thinking I want to start something like this, so then I can answer those questions to people.
Well, that's wonderful. Yeah. So today we are in Carlisle, Pennsylvania at the beautiful Yak and Yeti restaurant in Carlisle. And I'm so grateful that you are starting your first show here in a Bhutanese and Nepalese restaurant. So the one question, of course, that we must start off with mm-hmm. is, what is meditation?
So first I want to tell you, Susan, you know, when I travel around the world, you know, the people are so excited about the meditation. They want to meditate, but same time I can see people are so confused with the word meditation. Because modern world, people are using meditation for many different things, right? So what is the meditation? What is the purpose of the meditation? So in the Buddhist language, in Sanskrit or Pali, we have a word for meditation. We call bhavana, which translated as meditation. I think it is wrong. So bhavana means not meditation. I think it is cultivation, mm-hmm. mental culture, developing the mind. When we do meditation, what we are doing, we are developing our mind with good qualities, loving kindness, compassion, acceptance, letting go. When we are daily, we are doing meditation practices, that means every day we are getting better with those qualities. That is meditation all about.
Okay, that's wonderful, because I know sometimes people have heard the term meditation. Mm-hmm. That they have sometimes an idea that you're supposed to sit quiet,
right.
And they don't know what else to do. Mm-hmm. And when people try to sit quiet without going to a meditation class or one with you, mm-hmm. they always say that their mind is busy.
Right.
And so, how do you address those questions?
And my experience with people, many people come to meditation not to develop or cultivate their mind because they have a busy life. And so they want to have some time to relax their body and mind. Mm-hmm. So then they, when they do those exercises, I call the different meditation techniques, then they feel calm and relaxed and peaceful. Then they think, oh, I'm doing wonderful meditation, which is not. Right after having that experience, then they go outside. In real life, they don't have that experience anymore. Why? The world is so distracting, right? Mm-hmm. So then people think, I cannot quiet my mind when I'm at work, when I'm with my family members. Why is that? Don't try to even quiet your mind. There is no such thing. And so I think more than quieting your mind, better to learn how to calm your mind. So I feel when you say your mind is quiet, many people think it's almost like dead. Right? So I think calm mind, always active, and always doing things, always thinking, but it is so calm. So I think as a meditation practice, what we have to do, how we are going to calm down our mind, that is the real purpose.
So from what you were just saying, it sounds like meditation helps support these concerns that people say that they have. So mm-hmm. when they're saying, I can't meditate, my mind's so busy, mm-hmm. the process of meditation will help the mind. Mm-hmm. So why do we meditate?
So as I said, we have a busy mind. So when you don't have a calm mind, we don't know what we are doing. We cannot concentrate, we can focus, we are doing something here, we are doing something there. So when you are meditating every day, we have some time, like 2 minutes, I'm asking 2 minutes to sit down, I call the pause. Mm-hmm. Just stop everything, go within, and just observe your feeling and emotions, what is happening. So then allow yourself to calm down a little bit. Then you experience something clear in your life. When you have a very clear state of mind, then you can see the bottom, what is happening inside you. The analogy, the Buddhist teaching, it is like a lake or pond. If pond is murky and muddy, you cannot see the bottom. So that's why we have to meditate. That's the purpose. We have to keep our mind calm to get things done. So then we can concentrate, when we can focus, then exactly know what is happening. Then you can maintain your loving kindness. Then you can maintain your acceptance and letting go. Why everything is mindfully observed.
It sounds like it would actually really support a lot of relationships, whether they're friendships or husband and wife or even in work environment.
Right, because the biggest benefit I receive, how to deal with people, right? Because sometimes when we are living this world, we feel exhausted, we feel tired being in this world, dealing with situation and people, especially with people. How many times we had experienced, I'm tired being with these people, I want to run away. I go to somewhere else, peaceful island, then I have my own peace and I can enjoy my life. I don't think there's such a place for us to go. Place is right here, right now. After you experience your inner self, find calmness and peacefulness, then wherever you are, you can enjoy your life. So then, what is the problem people have with the relationship with other people? We are disconnected in our own mind. There's no connection inside us. So that means we are going through lots of challenges and difficulties with my own emotions. So then we are projecting those emotions to other people. When somebody says something, like for example, your husband says something to you, if you are not really focused well, you take it personally. So if you are very clear about yourself, doing wonderful with your practice, then you are listening really well what he meant, what he is trying to tell you. So then always you are ready to learn, so more than attacking to it. That's why people are always defensive. When people say something, always, oh, take it personally. That means ego kick in. Then we try to defend ourselves. But mindfulness practitioner, always say, thank you so much for sharing whatever you want to tell me. I'm listening. How you are going with that kind of mindset? Because of your practice, because of your awareness.
So that completely feeds to your mission of loving kindness.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. That is the loving kindness. People say loving kindness is go and help the world and do things for the people. That's a part of the loving kindness too. I think before we do to the world what we had to do, we had to do to ourselves. Love ourselves, being kind to ourselves. So I think, when I was a young monk, I was so annoying. I was a young, annoying monk. I remember when I was in the school, they don't like me. Because why? I'm projecting my negativities and my difficulties to other people. So right after I go inward, I call the introspection, go inward, I saw my challenges and my difficulties, my problems. Then little by little, with my own practice, with my own awareness, I start to work on them. Mm. Right after I work on them, then I realize I am getting better, I am more kind to myself, I am accepting who I am. Then whatever happening in the world after that, I am totally fine with that. Right? Whatever I am doing inside me, I am projecting to the world. I think that is the best meditation ever.
So, talking about the world. Some people have asked, they want to know, two questions, but in particular, what are the different kinds of meditation? Because there's so many for people to choose from, and you could just go to different teachers and different types.
That's another, the confusion, because when we have so many options, like in the United States, when you go to the grocery store, you have lots of options. So when you have many options, people are so confused. Now when we come to meditation, I can see many options. Why so many meditation teachers are here, so many meditation techniques are here. So now people go to place, teacher to teacher, technique to technique. So most of the meditation techniques in this part of the world, they are not real deep meditation practices. I call they are relaxation exercises. So it is beneficial. So when they are doing those practices, what will happen? they are calming down their mind and they go to the relaxed state of mind temporarily. When you experience something temporarily, then they feel good.
Mm-hmm.
Right after they feel good, what they want to do? They are in fantasy.
Mm-hmm.
But after that experience, then you go to real world. Then they are the same annoying people. Right? You know, so my point is, relaxation exercises are beautiful, get into that place. After you get into that place, you have to have a noble guidance. I call the noble teacher. Why? Teacher observes the student, reminding him or her, telling you are happy, you are sleeping now.
Mm-hmm.
You have to wake up. Right after you wake up from that sleep, then meditation begins. Why? Real meditation, we call the awakened mind, opposite of sleep.
Okay.
But now people are stuck here in this society, they are exhausted and tired. They are looking for opportunities to go and relax their mind and body.
Mm-hmm.
So after you go to a massage,
right,
then
yeah,
you feel so peaceful, calm, relaxed, and everything is there.
And you want to go back to massage 30 minutes later.
Right, exactly, that's what happening. But if you are really getting to the deeper observation and taking care of your own challenges and difficulties, go inward, like introspection, that experience you never lose. Why? It is your life experience.
Okay.
That is a real meditation practice.
And you talked before about the difference between training the mind and then meditation. Can you explain the difference?
So I think, you know, when you go to the meditation center or temple or retreat center, I call they are hospitals.
Okay.
Right? We are sick, we go and get the treatment.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we go meet a doctor. So then in the hospital, doctor giving you some kind of exercises to do, then you feel good. We are not planning to stay in the hospital forever. We are planning to go home. So then after we go home, we have to take care of ourselves in the world. So temple or meditation centers are like the training centers. We are training ourselves first, how to do it. Then we are going to practice it in the world. So the training and practice is totally two.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
I think so many of us think that the sitting down and, as you're going to, the training is the meditation,
yeah,
and then there's a disconnect when you go out into the world.
Right, exactly. You know, it's so funny to say this. You know, I experience here in this country, there are lots of addicts.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in the spiritual life, I can be, I can say another addict, I call the cushion addicts.
Oh.
Right? So they are so addicted to their cushion. How many hours I can sit as a meditation practitioner. But after they are doing 8 hours per day or 10-day vipassana retreat,
mm-hmm,
after they come home, still they are difficult people.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Whatever they did at the center, they didn't take it to the world. So what I'm asking, sitting and, you know, the doing that training part is so important. But end of the day, how you live your life, that is the real practice.
So when someone, though, is sitting on a cushion,
mm-hmm,
to train the mind,
mm-hmm,
you know, from being here in the United States now for so long, everyone says they don't have time.
Right.
So mm-hmm, is there, do you advise people to spend a certain amount of time to start?
Mm-hmm. That's a really good question. You know, if I say, can you practice meditation every day 1 hour, people say no. Now I know what to ask. I'm asking people, can you spend 2 minutes every single day,
mm-hmm,
to meditate? 2 minutes is enough. If you do 2 minutes really well, then you feel good with that. Then you can do 5 minutes. So make a small steps. Right? Don't make a big plan to meditate. Just morning, wake up, make your coffee, sit down, and close your eyes. Do 2 minutes meditation. You know, bring some loving awareness to yourself and focus on your breath. That's perfect.
That's easy.
Yeah, that's very easy. I know I ask many people around the world to do this 2 minutes meditation. I know many people doing really well,
mm-hmm,
in their spiritual journey. That's why I keep asking people, try to practice 2 minutes meditation every day.
So one of the last questions that I have, people want to know from you, is that can they practice meditation,
mm-hmm,
despite what religion they are?
Oh, yeah, I think this is a perfect, you know, really good question. Because always people ask me this question, because especially here in this country, United States, people are coming from the different religious background. They have different faith. That's why at actually my temple we have Buddha and Jesus both are there. And I think real meditation is not belong to any religion. It is universal truth. So you, if you have your own religion, you can follow your religion, but still you can meditate. So meditation is taking care of our own mind, nothing to do with the religion. So if you have one, please respect it, just follow it, go to the church and totally fine. But same time, you can meditate too. You know, practice loving kindness, practice mindfulness is not a religion. It is way of life.
Bhante, thank you so much for allowing me to ask you these questions.
Thank you so much for doing this.
Stay tuned for the next episode of Choose Loving Kindness with Venerable Bhante Sujatha.